Almost like a foreign city in the midst of America is New Orleans. Of another world are its Mardi Gras, its river levees, its picturesque alleys, its easygoing, peaceful life. And this old world city, in fact, the entire state of Louisiana, is in the grip of a decidedly un-American dictatorship of the loudest character the national political scene has heard in a generation. Long is the name, and long is the way this unusual man has come in the last 7 years. A year later, he was impeached by Louisiana's House of Representatives on 19 assorted charges, from corruption to gross misconduct. But he already controlled the state Senate, and he wriggled out of the impeachment to become a minor national figure, rowdy and vivid. From 1928 on, his doings are news. When the German cruiser Emden visits New Orleans, its commander calls formally on Louisiana's governor. Informal reception brings a demand for an official apology. Next day, in dress clothes borrowed piece by piece from friends, he returns the call and receives the governor's salute. Frankly a demagogue, he had been elected through his appeal to the people up the bayou. He promised and he gave them new roads, free bridges instead of toll bridges, a new state capitol, and to himself a new governor's mansion, upping the state's debt 300%, but giving jobs to thousands who will vote for Huey Long. Great fun has the self-styled kingfish in running Louisiana. With rare self-consciousness, he accepts an honorary doctorate of laws from Loyola University. His pretty typist he makes Secretary of State and lets her run Louisiana when he is away.
As the First Lady Governor of Louisiana, I want to take this opportunity to thank my many friends for...
In 1932, Huey Long has himself elected to the United States Senate.
I'm very proud to be here tonight and know this is the proudest moment of my husband's career.
Well, it's been a great evening.
As the newly elected senator, I've done all I can for Louisiana. Now I want to help the rest of the country. Louisiana's kingfish graduates to the national political stage, is greeted in Washington by Democratic Senate leader Joseph T. Robinson.
Thank you, Senator Robinson. I'm certainly glad to be with you.
To run his state, Dictator Long puts in O.K. Allen, his good-natured henchman, now puppet governor of Louisiana. To his new friends in Washington, Huey boasts that back in Louisiana, he has the best legislature money can buy. But away from home, Huey's rowdiness is not so well received. At a Long Island club in August 1933, his senatorial immunity is no help to him. A medal paid for by public subscription memorializes the national black eye of the kingfish from Louisiana. But Huey Long has come a long way from the washroom of 1933. Popular response to his Share the Wealth movement floods his space in the Senate office building.
Hello. What I called you about was to see if there's any chance of my getting anywhere at all to get a little more space around here temporarily. I don't know what to do. I'll put these people out in the hall and let these senators fuss and probably want to throw us all out of here. I don't know what we're going to do with it because we've got more than we can handle. I'm going to give up this office to the stenographers and move out to some place around the hotel. I wish you'd let me know.
And now the Louisiana kingfish, having grown too big for Louisiana, too big for the U.S. Senate, eyes the biggest office in the country, the executive office at the White House. Today, Huey Long is the biggest single threat to the re-election of Franklin D. Roosevelt. He shrewdly broadcasts Share the Wealth promises in specific terms. $5,000 a year, and every man a king.
Mr. Moore, $5,000. $5 million to any one man.
Thus, Huey Long revamps for his candidacy of 1936 the broad doctrine of social justice propounded by the candidate of 1932.
Men and women forgotten in the political philosophy of the government of the last 12 years, look to us here for guidance and for a more equitable opportunity to share in the distribution of national wealth.